Thank you very much, Secretary General, distinguished panelists, ladies and gentlemen. As we have been hearing, and I repeat for emphasis, SIDS, including CARICOM states and the wider Caribbean, are at the front lines of the climate change crisis. CARICOM states and all SIDS continue to bear the brunt of global climate change that we do not cause. Altogether, SIDS are responsible for less than 1% of global carbon emissions. SIDS' ongoing climate change challenges are unprecedented. Extreme heat, extreme weather, sea level rise, warming, ocean temperatures are all creating a perfect storm that can reverse all our gains suddenly or progressively because of their cascading and compounding impacts. I have been asked to say a bit about what AI brings to this unprecedented set of crises. AI is rapidly being deployed to tackle the climate crisis on multiple fronts. It's enhancing our ability to predict and prepare for extreme weather events like hurricanes, wildfires, by analyzing massive climate data sets. AI can help monitor and protect ecosystems by tracking things like shoreline change, loss of territory, and deforestation with unprecedented speed and accuracy. AI accelerates climate research by analyzing complex data, making timely analyses and policy development possible at levels previously unattainable. However, it is crucial to develop and use AI responsibly. We know the mischief that AI can be programmed to do. We have already been fighting misinformation and climate skepticism. A strategy to counter this climate misinformation may be timely. There are also emerging discussions of the carbon footprint and sustainability elements of AI and supercomputing that will need to be addressed. Within CARICOM, we have been developing our ICT for Development policy and program, including the creation of a regional AI policy to consider its role in sustainability and climate action. But the riddle that has to be solved with a much greater sense of urgency is the access to finance on affordable and appropriate terms to make it possible to do all we need to do to build resilience to climate change, including deployment of AI. What is true is that the longer the G20, who are responsible for 80% of global emissions, the longer they take to reduce these emissions that are at the core of the climate crisis, the larger the amount of funding necessary to address the impact of climate change on all of us. But especially SIDS, who, as I said, are responsible for less than 1% of emissions. And SIDS need real finance. We welcome the commitment made at COP26 to double climate adaptation finance by 2025. But we have to underscore the importance of its materialization and operationalization. Same can be said for the Loss and Damage Fund. We urge that the board, together with the newly appointed ED, move swiftly to put in place the necessary arrangements to ensure the fund is fit for purpose for SIDS and can deploy resources as soon as 2025. Resources are urgently necessary, simply and directly, in amounts commensurate with actual needs. We already know there's a significant finance gap for keeping global warming below 1.5. Further, SIDS receive only 2% of the global public finance, which is not even evenly spread across SIDS. The picture worsens when considering the debt of SIDS. According to the World Bank, over a third of SIDS have relatively high public debt ratios, with 14 being assessed as high risk for sovereign debt distress. Not only are we paying for the climate crisis, We are also committing future generations to debt because of lack of international support. So this COP must deliver a finance climate goal that is credible and consequential for 1.5. SIDS do not have the luxury of time. We must ensure that we solve the problem of access to resources to address our vulnerabilities. We cannot ease up on our insistence that those countries responsible for the emissions that cause climate change take effective action to reduce their emissions. And as we move ahead, we ask the UN system to evaluate the effectiveness of this process and whether it is delivering to those of us who are on the front lines. Thank you very much.